Lonely Planet can probably help you. It is the world's leading travel guide, and this year it marks its 40th anniversary. It was created by Tony Wheeler and his wife after they went on their honeymoon. Tony, good morning.
Good morning.
You have been to over 150 countries. Where are some of the hot spots that people may not know about?
Well,
Charlie wants to know.
Right now, this is a wet spot, isn't it?
Yes.
Croatia, the coast of the Adriatic coast, which used to be Yugoslavia, and now it's a bunch of countries, Slovenia, Croatia, Montenegro, and it's just a beautiful region. Really nice little towns, and the best way to do it, if you can get a boat and go down the coast on a boat, that would be the that would be the ideal trip. Mm-hmm. I've been back many times to Nepal. I'm a keen walker, and you know, to walk up to the Everest base camp, to walk around the Annapurna Mountains, to walk around the Buddha stupas, they're all great things to do. So Nepal's a real favorite for me.
And how up are the base camps?
Well, the base camp is, you know, the air's getting pretty thin when you get there. You're a lot of places in the world, that's twice as high as you'd ever get in a lot of countries.
Okay, third is?
I think China is a place that's terrifically interesting these days. So many of us are interested in what's happening there, and it's always fascinating to see a place like that where so many things
What's the greatest beach in the world?
The greatest beach. Well, I'm from Australia, so you know we put our claim in, whether it's a city beach, Bondi Beach in Sydney, or some of the beaches up on the Great Barrier Reef.
Undiscovered cities in France?
The cities
are worth... segment about you, Charlie.
Yes.
Yeah, I know he's planning a summer here. Charlie's planning a summer. You guys take it off set later.
All right, I'm sorry.
No, but one of the things that I like about what Lonely Planet does, you have ten top tips, and two really struck out for me. I'm not winking at you. My contact is bothering me. I'm not trying to be cute, but my contact is killing me at this particular
moment.
Could
have fooled me.
Hello. But two of your top tips. One was step outside your comfort zone. I want you to elaborate on that. And the other that I thought was interesting is don't over economize. Don't miss out on a great experience for a couple of bucks. So talk about those two.
Absolutely. There's nothing worse than coming back and you know you saved your $10 or $20, but you passed up something. And at the time, it seemed worth saving the money. But years later, you'll be saying, why didn't I do that?
Yes.
Why didn't I go there? And unfortunately, I've got a few things that I think I wish
that
I'd been there at the time.
Mm-hmm. And stepping out of your comfort zone, what do you mean?
Well, when we travel, we want to just think different. We don't want to eat the food we always eat at home.
Yeah.
Comfort food's a great thing, but sometimes a little bit of discomfort really helps.
Really? Okay. All right. Charlie, what else do you need as you're planning?
Well, I'm really interested in exotic places that we don't know about. I mean, there must be some places in Africa, for example, that would be wonderful. Go ahead.
Africa is terrific. I've been to Africa a lot of times, and I've never been to Africa and not had a good time. Mm-hmm. I've met great people, great experiences, and taking kids there when the kids were young, kids love it. The whole thing with that. It's
Tony,
one thing seeing an animal in the zoo, in the
world. A lot of good ideas, Tony. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Pleasure to have you here.